just need a moment to quickly take the...
Dad never used to be like this. It's all my fault.
What? How so?
You can deceive the eyes, but you can't deceive the heart. This line is at the beginning and also the end of Aranara's vow. I'm certain that in 100 years' time, this line will become a famous proverb in Sumeru. Don't you think?
Huh?
I'm okay. You guys go ahead. I'm just a little tired.
Sounds a bit sassy to me.
Hey, look! There's a note here! Could this be the evidence that Tanjiro was talking about? The handwriting's so hard to read! It's too hard! I can't remember the names of all these mushrooms. Do Aranara need to learn about mushroom classification? Here's another note that says, "This tree hollow is my castle." That sounds more like something an Aranara from the stories would say.
What the fuck is today? Monday.
There's another one here! If only I were a clever Aranara. A clever Aranara. Is the emphasis on clever or Aranara?
How does it feel to bear witness to a groundbreaking discovery? Exciting, isn't it? The crude handwriting may look like a child's, but don't forget, we're in the middle of a rainforest.
What is the thing around
there? I doubt
that
a child would be able to reach this deep into the forest, and I doubt even more that they would think of this lowly tree hollow as some sort of impenetrable castle.
That is exactly what a child would do.
I boldly hypothesize that this tree hollow is, in fact, the Aranara's academia. The notes we saw were written by the Aranara themselves. There is no doubt in my mind about that. An Aranara that wasn't so bright left a note here wishing to become a clever Aranara. Oh, I shall craft a new story for them and call it The Aranara in the Tree Hollow. How's that? Don't the very words just conjure up images of Aranara in your mind's eye?
Nope.
Well, many an adventurer knows how to take to the skies with their easily visible wind gliders, yet they do not possess the invisible wings of imagination, making it hard for them to keep up with my train of thought. How about you, Miss Forest Ranger? Do you soar into the atmosphere on the wings of imagination?
Huh? Me? I don't know. Maybe I do, but maybe not. Anyway... It has nothing to do with me, so... Yeah, I'm fine. It's just that... Witnessing Tanja's creative process is a little...
Overwhelming.
Oh, yes. Yes, overwhelming.
For now, I've decided to stay here with Razi until we witness the legendary moment when the Aranara appear in this hollow. Don't worry, I won't let the Akara Crafts Toymakers down. When a real Aranara appears, their little troubles will be resolved in an instant.
He seems pretty stubborn. Looks like we'll have to stay here and wait a little longer.
No, I think we should return to our camp first. Tanja, in Aranara and the Three Little Fungus, it says that Aranara are very sensitive creatures. I don't think they'll show up if we stay here.
Oh? Was that in the story? Ah! Yes, I remember now. Miss Forest Ranger, you sure know your stuff. In that case, let's go back to camp and call it a day. We'll continue our search for evidence first thing in the morning.
Go to the encampment at night. Okay. Okay, I have to turn the air on for right now because... it is important.
Traveler! Traveler! Wake up! It's not the Arinara! It's Kale! She's gone! Oh, Paimon's been worried about Kale.
She's probably fucking locked in another quest.
She kept telling us she was okay after we saw the evidence of Arinara activity. She's been acting kind of strange. Anyway, let's go find her.
Maybe she's been captured by the Arinara and is going to be turned into marinara sauce.
Aren't these Kale's footprints? But why are they headed towards the tree hollow?
Hold on, I'm trying to clean my glasses. Find Kale. Kale is bit. Oh, don't you fucking tell me. Are you kidding me? Okay, this is just unacceptable now. At this point, what the fuck is the fucking point? We said goodbye to her. I get to come to this fucking event to do one dialogue of anything, and then suddenly she's fucking locked behind something again. What is keeping her from being able to be in this quest? Watch this. There she is. She's here just fine. I don't see what the fucking problem is.
All right, a mute.
Okay, I think I'm gonna say fuck this event because this is actually getting really infuriating at this point. It's not acceptable. It's not a joke anymore for me. I get to come back to the event, do a little bit, like literally a few lines of dialogue, and then she's locked behind something. Then I get to continue, then she's locked behind something. Then I get to continue, then she's locked behind something. Literally, like 3 times now, this has happened in the span. I've been able to spend about 30 minutes on this event and over 2 hours on the fucking Sumeru questline, which I specifically tried skipping because it gives you the option to skip the Archon quest. What the fuck is the goddamn point? If it just screws you. I don't want to sit here and do all of the freaking Sumeru quests just so that I can do the event shit when they give you an option to quick start the damn thing. Like, what? Fuck's sake, what the hell is keeping her this time? What was the fucking point in saying goodbye to her and trailing off on our own just for her to get locked behind the damn thing again?
One moment, please, you two. It appears this is your first time visiting Sumeru City.
Oh, yeah, that's right. But how did you know that?
Because there's currently no information on either of you in the Akasha. But no need to worry, that won't prevent you from entering the city. In fact, the Academia conveniently provides each traveler to Sumeru City with a device. Perhaps you too have heard of the Akasha before. It's our beloved Greater Lord Rukadavata's lasting legacy, a treasure trove of collected knowledge. After centuries of tireless research on the Akasha, the Academia created one of its most ingenious inventions, the Akasha Terminal. As long as you are within Sumeru's borders, you may use an Akasha Terminal to connect directly to the Akasha and access any knowledge you need. I should mention that due to technical limitations, the operation of Akasha Terminals will be much smoother and more effective in large cities such as Sumeru City and Port Ormos.
It sounds pretty amazing.
You two are quite fortunate. Until recently, it was standard practice to only issue Akasha terminals to outlanders who spent an extended amount of time in Sumeru. However, this policy was recently changed, and now all travelers are issued one upon arrival. Here are your Akasha terminals. Please handle them with care.
It kind of looks like a leaf.
To activate it, simply hold it in your hand and say the following phrase to yourself. May the mighty God bless us with their voice of wisdom.
Oh, since this little doodad lets you access knowledge, maybe we can use it to find a way to meet Lesser Lord Kusanali. Let's give it a try. May the mighty God bless us with their voice of wisdom. Whoa! Just now, something clicked, and Paimon suddenly knew how to use this thing! It seems all we need
what
to do
fuck?
Is concentrate on what we want to know, and bam! You get it! Oh, that'll come in real handy!
Exactly! That is the power of the Akasha. And with that, let me officially welcome you both to Sumeru City. May the wisdom of the Dendro Archon always be your guide.
Okay, now that we're in, we can check the Akasha about Lesser Lord Kusanali. Let Paimon try. 500 years ago, the sages found a newly born deity from within some scorched ruins. The deity now resides in the sanctuary of Suristana. Seems pretty similar to what Kali was telling us. Okay, next, let's concentrate on asking how to meet her. Huh? Paimon doesn't sense anything. The Akasha didn't respond to Paimon's question. Oh, come on! Focusing on this question feels like when you have something you're trying to remember and it's on the tip of your tongue, but you just can't think of it. Paimon's brain is exhausted. Oh! Smart idea! But what are you going to ask it? Paimon's getting all teary-eyed all of a sudden. It feels like the people of Sumeru really missed their Archon. You too? Well, glad it's not just Paimon. We're outlanders, and we've only just arrived in Sumeru? You know, maybe we're not qualified to receive an answer to this sort of question or something. Well, seems no matter which way we try, we can't find anything that'll lead us to Lesser Lord Kusanali. guess our only choice now is to try meeting with the researcher that Tainari recommended. He's from Sumeru, and even has a position in the academia. Maybe he'll be able to access more info from the Akasha. Let's see. Tainari wrote an address on the letter's envelope. Oh, it's not far from the city's gate. Let's head over and have a look.
Wait, what the fuck? Why can we do it now? This is baffling. That doesn't make any fucking sense. Or are we gonna go over there and it's gonna be like, oh, now we have to use our internet ear thing that we have now. And that's why it was locked off, because it was very clearly because Kale was being interrupted by something. But what the hell does that have to do with Kale, what I just did? Is it her little hideout?
If I'd known, I would have just told the tree hollow instead of writing it down. There must be another way to practice my handwriting. Now I've created a whole new problem for myself. What do I do now? Dress up as an Haranara? Oh, no, that won't work. I should be writing something that an Haranara would never say, so the Tanja won't mistake me for one of them. Oh. But what should I write? Oh, I've got it! There's no way Tanja could see this as the work of an Haranara.
So the evidence of Haranara activity we saw during the day was actually evidence of Kali's activity. But why didn't she just tell Tanja? Oh, right! Kale told Razi that he could tell any secret to a tree hollow. Must be because that's what she does. And now she even writes it down. Yeah, you're right. We'll keep her secret for her. Oh, looks like she's almost done writing. Let's head back.
That's not interact. F is interact.
Aha! There's a new note just as
aha,
I expected.
Another air vent.
Yes. It's the same handwriting, which means it must have been written by the same Haranara. Let's see what it says.
Ooh, what could it be?
What could it be?
I want to visit Mondstadt during the Ludi Harpastum again? No, that's impossible. This must be some kind of mistake. How could an Haranara go to Mondstadt for the Ludi Harpastum? Even I would never write that into a fairy tale.
So, in other words, the notes can't have been left by an Haranara.
If you ask me, they were probably left by a passing merchant from Mondstadt or something. Definitely not an Haranara.
No, I refuse to believe it. I can't.
What do you mean you can't? It's not like it'll take you a huge amount of effort.
You've written so many stories beloved by the children. I'm sure you can help create carvings that are just as successful.
No! I can't do it.
Damn.
I thought that if I could find an Haranara, I'd be able to help Akara crafts. But it was someone from Mondstadt all along.
But you've managed to write all those stories without ever having seen a real Haranara, right? What makes this so different?
I...
Because I'm the one who wrote the stories.
Really? Can I?
Yes, it's fine. Tell them. I know this is the moment you've been waiting for.
Okay. Kale, Traveler, Paimon, do you remember when I said that there was a secret I didn't want to tell anyone?
I write the stories.
I didn't want to tell anyone the secret, but it made me feel very sad and also turned Dad into a completely different person. So, I think I should tell you. Dad isn't the one who came up with all those Aranara stories.
What? Hold on. So if Uncle Tanja wasn't the author, then who was it? Wait. You don't mean...
It was me. Dad's been telling stories in Port Ormos for as long as I can remember. I always got to listen to all his new stories. Every night, Dad would give me a Zaytun peach for dinner, and I'd eat it while he told his stories. The Zaytun peaches were delicious, but Dad's stories were really bad. He always uses sentences that are really hard to understand, and... strange, metaphors, I think they're called? But Dad kept on going, telling his stories again and again. Oh, one time, he even borrowed a camera from Lord Sangemabe's shop and got me to take pictures of him in action. Dad showed me the picture and said that it shall become the precious record of Sumero's best storyteller early in his career. Even though I only had Zaytun peaches to eat and not so great stories to listen to, I was happy. Then one day, I tried telling Dad a story I came up with. Dad seemed really excited from the very beginning. He looked really happy. He lifted me up high into the air and told me to continue. He lifted me up so high that I was looking down at him. As I continued with my story, I saw his expression gradually change. And when I got to my favorite part, Dad started crying. I guess he must have been moved by my story. When Dad put me back down, I looked up at him again, but now he had a scary look in his eyes.
You remember it so vividly!
It's not only Rozzy. I, too, remember every detail of what happened that day. After that, I gradually grew in fame and started making money. I became Sumeru's best storyteller, just as I always dreamed. Finally, we could afford more than just Zaytun peaches for dinner. I thought it would make Rozzy happy.
I was really happy at first, but then everyone started calling me Tanja's son instead of Rozzy. I kind of guessed why, but I also didn't want to believe it. Dad got busier with things that had nothing to do with storytelling. Like that request from Akara Crafts. So I made up my mind that this time, I just want to be good old Rozzy so that Dad will become good old Dad again. Instead of Dad the way he is now, starting every story with, "Dedicated to my dearest Rozzy." I prefer my dad how he used to be, stumbling over words and not knowing how to end the story. That's why I decided to keep how I imagine R&R to look like a secret.
Wait, Paimon gets it now! To sum up, all of Uncle Tanja's fairy tales were actually stories written by Rozzy. And because Rozzy didn't want Tanja to keep living a lie, he refused to help him with Akara Crafts commission.
Yes. That's why I tried looking for possible evidence of Aranara. But it turned out that I was just being a clown, as always. Not even a funny one. I'm a terrible father.
No, you're fine.
I'm sorry, Rozzy. I'm so sorry.
And I owe you all an apology, too, for wasting your time. Razi's the only one who can help Akara Crafts. If you can manage to persuade him, that is. Right now, I think I just want to find a tree hollow and be quiet for a while.
Are we gonna let this happen?
You want me to help Akara Crafts with their carving? Well, I did mention what the R&R look like in my stories, but to make a carving, we might need more details. Kale, Traveler, and Paimon, I might need your help on this one.
Okay.
I've never really left Port Ormos before. This is my first time in Gandharvaville. Well, it's my first time being so far from home. Sumeru is so much bigger than I thought. Seeing new places has given me loads of new ideas for my R&R stories. So I want to visit more places in Sumeru. That way, I can help Akara Crafts create an R&R carving that everyone will love. And I also want to take pictures of Dad everywhere that we travel to.
You still want me to come with you? Even after all I've done?
Yeah, of course. Come on. You're the best dad ever.
This is the happiest Razi has sounded since we met him.
I want to thank you, Kale.
Huh? Me? I didn't do anything to help.
You told me about telling my secrets to a tree hollow. Even though I didn't have the time to find a tree hollow, telling everyone my secret made me feel so much better.
Yeah, it's hard to keep too many secrets. And there's no need to hide our mistakes from others all the time. I made a lot of mistakes back in Mondstadt. But when I look back on them, it all feels more like a new beginning. I'm sure this experience will be the same for Tanja.
Yes. I'll do my best to become a good father again. Wait. Did you just say you've been to Mondstadt?
Oops.
I just passed by once. Never mind that. Come on now. Akara Crafts is waiting for us. Let's go, Razi. Grab that camera and see what hidden inspiration you can discover along the way.
Okay, let's go. Come on, Dad.
Come on, Dad. Let's go.
Razi, slow down and watch your step.
Yeah!
But dude... You will discover all sorts of new and fascinating things while exploring Sumeru, so why not use the exquisitely crafted camera to record them down? While using the camera, if the viewfinder has objects worth keeping a record of in view, the camera will display information related to them. Adjust your photo taking distance and camera zoom to more easily spot these designated photo targets. Also, the camera is only to be used in Sumeru.
The 20th anniversary of Akara Crafts is coming up! Paimon wonders what the children thought of the R&R carvings we helped create. Let's go check it out!
What? Okay, hold on. Let me get that camera in my inventory here. What's worth taking? It showed a cat thing in the... Did the kids like new carving? Did Tanja repent? Go to Port Ormos to find out. Okay, well, I guess. I don't know what the picture thing is. Does it say? And oh, okay. And now we've got the whole quest thing opened up. So, let me see. So, metamorphosis of wood. Metamorphosis. Damn it. Assemble the carving components to craft an R&R carving and put smiles on the kids' faces. So, assemble two complete carvings. Okay, I have no idea. Carving components. I don't know where to get the carving components. But whatever. That's that. Go to showcase. Okay, that's down there.
What was that?
So, I don't know what that is yet. Roaming the jungle. This might be the picture one. Raven Innocence. Yeah, that's got a big old cameras. Rainforest creature. Shroombor, Duskbird, and Quick-Tempered Rishboland Tigers. Okay, so I guess this is like my challenge list then. Try Lakshana creatures. Okay, this looks like we've got a lot of stuff going on here. What the hell? Oh no, they want me to fight. Okay, so this must be camera challenges, and then I guess boss fight challenges, and then running. And then this looks like fighting. And then whatever this is. Okay, I guess that's what that quest is for. Event shop. Okay, this is how we get the parts. We have to buy them. And then there's also this stuff here. Okay, so I guess we'll just work our way down to where the quest is and take a picture on the stuff along the way. Oh, there's already stuff available. Oh, there's already a camera here. Well, hold on. Let me navigate to that then quick. Let me just do that. It looks like now that the Kale stuff issues are out of the way, we might be able to just, you know, actually do the fucking event. Okay, so let's see. What is this? Grove Dash. The time elapsed while clearing the Grove Dash challenge number of venture count coins. Yeah, okay. Score. Okay. The poop. Oh. Okay. Over the bridge. All right, now let me see what this camera is. So if the camera just takes you to a place to take a picture, I thought maybe I'd have to actually look around for them myself, which I wouldn't mind. I don't mind having to do that too much. But of course, on a time-gated thing, it helps to be pointed in the right direction. I'm going the wrong way, aren't I? It's over that way. Shroom bears in this area, okay. Allow me to do some mining. Got it. I don't think that was a really good picture, but okay, so camera, so yes, shroom boar. I said shroom bear, I think. To four that we need to do. All right, fine. That's good. Then I'll just leave that as is until we go along with it. So there's another camera over here and a fighting thing. I'm just going to scrounge these up as we see them. These don't seem like they're going to be too difficult or too grindy. I should do the thing that I've done before where we worry about doing the quest of the event first. You know, since that's like kind of the most important part, and then we come back and do all of the little bonus stuff. But it looks like in order to really even do much of the other stuff, I need to get those materials that I get from doing these little challenges, so. I will open up that fast travel point, though, while we are here. seems to be a shaggy whatever that said. I have no idea what that is. Guess I'll have to look for it. Bam bam, the city where all wisdom resides. Oh, it might be these things down here. Shaggy Sumpter Beast. Alright, we did that. Very nice, very easy. Braving the Elements gameplay tutorial. In the Braving the Elements challenge, when characters on the field trigger Quicken, Aggravate, Spread, Bloom, Hyperbloom, Burgeon, or Burning reaction to unleash a shockwave at the point where the reaction takes place, dealing true damage. Well, unfortunately, I don't have anybody with green. The green, you know, not green, but just green. I don't know what I'm doing here.
Emerge.
I guess we're just fighting all this stuff. Says defeat 12 enemies.
Right now, emerge. Right now,
blaze into light.
At least they're dropping shit.
Here, emerge right now.
Allow me. Boing, boing, boom. Pew.
La la la. Oh no, I did not mean to press Q. Okay, well we did it, I think, but yeah, we need a Dendro character in our party to really make good use of that, which I guess we do have access to. Like, we have Kale, but she's not going to help us because she's level 1. And we could use the Traveler. I might have plans to enter a Dendro character into the party, though. Because I think it would work very well with Klee. Okay, so now where? Okay, the camera. We've got a camera and a running thing over here. The running things are pretty alright. Spino Crocodile. Okay, I think this is something that Aki actually fought on her world, but I didn't really get to see. Yeah, these things down here. I think I saw them from above, but didn't get close enough because they were all dead. Well, let's see. Kind of cool looking. Right there, right now. We don't really have the time.
Let's move out. Yeah.
Bam, bam. Got the gold. I guess collecting all the coins pretty much ensures that you'll get everything from it. You'll need it. We'll just have to remember that we've done that one, because these ones are repeatable. Okay, we've got another one there, two fighting things, two things there. Okay, so I guess we will head south next. These won't take too long at all, I don't think. The boss things scare me a little bit. Because any kind of boss fighting to do in one of these events, I always remember that one that we did a while back, last year, in Inazuma. When we first fought that mechanical boss or whatever. Because that one was so grindy, because you had to keep fighting the same boss over and over and over again, like 10 times or something. But we'll see. Okay, it looks like we could afford to climb here. Up, up and away. Defeat 12 opponents. Oh, well, this time it's not those little shroom guys. This time it's these guys.
Emerge right now.
No, no, let me out of the way.
Animal test 6308.
Right here. Emerge. Right now.
Blazing to light. Woo!
Good to get some crafting materials for this region, though.
Emerge right now, right here.
Stand clear. Absorption test. Hold the line.
What the fuck? The next fighting thing just appeared right down here. How long does the wish have, by the way? 19 hours. Okay, so we'll be doing what pulls I can, at least to try. I'm gonna get at least Dory. At least I'll try, that is, because I don't know. We might get really unlucky.
Right now.
Looking for trouble.
Allow me.
Looking for trouble.
Oh, you shit fucker.
Emerge right here.
Stand clear.
Following order.
Okay, that wasn't so bad. Alright, now, where's the next thing? I thought there was something else nearby. Another fighting thing just down... Oh yeah, there's a runny thing over there. Fuck it, I might as well go do that. I don't know how many of these there are. In total, though. I didn't look deep into the challenge list. Because it seems to be a lot of pictures that we'll have to take. Like, can I take a picture of this cat thing before we even have it unlocked to do? Oh, it looks like we can. Okay, that actually worked. Which means if I come across, like, a creature or something, I can take a picture of it then. And then we'll get a little bit of progress so that I don't have to worry about it later. Now it says that, I thought there were, does it have an enemy one? Like, can I take a picture of these guys? No. Okay.
Needs to be creatures, mate. Mate!
Why this one? This fighting one only has 7 enemies. Oh, because there's a big enemy. I don't know if I necessarily remember this. I didn't get a tutorial, so we'd probably come across him at some point, even if it was in co-op, but...
Now you're testing my patience.
Come on, he can die, he can die! Oh, took some damage, it's fine. What's the fuck? There's another fighting thing down here. Okay, well let me look and see here at this event progress, because I want to make sure if I'm missing anything. New. Okay. Oh, I guess that was the next one we needed to do, but we didn't go to where it wanted us to, I guess. Okay, so we've got some whimsical drafts, money and crafting materials, or talent materials, I'm assuming that's what those are. So number 2 is... I don't know, because there seems to be a lot more pictures here. Animal behavior. So apparently I've gotten some playing with tail. So I guess I've taken pictures of them doing certain things. Wait patiently to record various behaviors of different individuals. Eating, resting, and attacking. Okay, well I think the attacking one will be pretty easy. Chapter of foliage. Right? I'll skip that right now. Okay, this is the running challenges. Okay, so we did that one. So we get primogems for this. For the running ones. We haven't done that one yet. We have done this one. We haven't done those. Okay, and then the fighting ones. Okay, it looks like there's quite a few. Gonna worry about the bosses right now. I'll worry about that a little bit later.
I'll get grounded for a whole day, but it's way worth it because the fish tastes so good.
Oh, good, it's more of these people. I like fighting these guys. They usually come in big groups, and it's nice to group them all together with some crows. Speaking of which,
Swirl, new punch. Right now, right here, emerge.
Jumpy,
jumpy, go! You are not. Oh, we're doing this again, huh? Shit, shit, shit.
Sight to behold. Right now. I'm getting sick of this.
Why is there 3 enemies, but there's only 2 more we have to kill? Dude, they just raped Klee, like, instantly. What the fuck? I got hit, like, 2 or 3 times and I was dead. Finish this guy off with Sucrose and Miko. Okay, that's another fighting thing down. Let me grab this fast travel point here quick. And then what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to fast travel back to a statue to get Klee back. Oh. I'm gonna keep an eye on this stuff while I have the chance. It was part four of that one. Okay. And then I can just fast travel back over and do it this way. See? Bish bash bob. Bish bash bosh, rather, not bob. Shit, I don't have the right character for this. Whatever.
Welcome.
Only three enemies. Whoops. No, 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 I don't want to get fucked again.
Absorption test.
That was easy. Holy crap. It was only three enemies. They were bigger, scarier enemies, but still. I think Aki's online doing her chasm quest right now. I'm not 100% positive. Well, we can actually look and see. Friends. She's indeed online right now. Okay. We got an achievement. When was that? Hear the voice of divine wisdom. I guess that was to get access to the thing. Okay, so now it wants me to go... There's a camera thing right up here. I don't know, what am I looking for here? One of those things. Okay, so plant stuff. Did that count? Does it need to be lit up? Hello? Jeez. Picture taking done. Oh, is there just another thing here? Huh? Oh, let me see. What is that? Yes, that's great. I'll worry about that later. Something else here that is it was one of those. Maybe it's trying to tell me that there's something else it wants me to take a picture of here. All right, hold on. Let me look at this again. Camera. So the first challenge is done. So activated and not activated. I took pictures of. So there's something else, I guess, that we need to do. I don't really understand what I'm looking at here. Contain an abundant amount of dendro. They will enter an activated state under the influence of electro and the scorched state when affected by pyro. Okay, so maybe if I fuck it with some pyro, I can take another picture of it. Maybe that's why it's still marked. Okay, now Z. Scorched, yeah. Okay, so that's what I needed to do. Alright. Okay, so... next, I will pee because I have to pee again. But where does it want us to go next? Okay, there's a camera down here. So I will do that. Okay, we're blazing through these. I'm happy because there'll be a nice chunk of primogems for it, so that I can hopefully get Dory. But it's pee time first. Do I need to take a picture of that thing? No,